we're going to go and break this off. So I'm going to grab it with a cold tool, and then Kate's going to go and tap the end. Okay. This is blunt force trauma. So if you've got a really, really delicate punty, and you go, and start whacking at the glass, there's always a good possibility that this could fall off.
Okay, this, that can certainly happen.
There are some ways to go and mitigate some risk.
One way to mitigate risk is to make sure that the glass is hot when you tap it. Okay?
I'm not really breaking the glass off.
I am breaking the glass off, but I'm not breaking it when the glass is cold. I'm breaking it when the glass is hot. Hot glass is easier to break than cold glass.
So what I'm going to do is I'm going to cool the inside real quick. I'm going to pull the outside, and I should still be able to go and I should still feel a little bit of movement. Yeah. Okay, it's going to whack, and it'll come right off.
Okay.
But
the type of movement I should feel, what you're not sure. What you're not sure. What you're not sure. That's what you
risk. So when you go and do the jack and whack, the best way to mitigate risk is to make sure that you've got a cold tool on it and somebody else is whacking. That way the piece is supported at all times. And this is my shape, okay, where my shape is wider than it is tall. Okay. When I go to tap this off, okay, it's not going to want to tap off real well. I mean, I can go and get the shape to tap off, and people can go and get the shape to tap off, don't get me wrong. What's better is a shape that's caved in. That's taller than it is wide. Okay. Now when I go and bring my neck down, I'm going to do one more thing. I'm going to open the valve. Okay, so if I use my jacks or if I use my diamond shears on it before I bring it down, I'm going to close the valve. But what I want to do before I tap it, I'm going to open it first.
Oh.
Thing off however you want. And it can go and work for you. Okay. What I'm showing you is a good, sensible way to whack it off so you can mitigate risk. Don't get me wrong. You can whack off any shape that you want on the end of this. Okay? And it may work and it may not work. Okay? And that's fine. Just like, you know,
so you're saying we can whack off any way we want, right?
Yeah. So you guys can whack off any way you want. Okay, so I'm going to go and open the valve because I'm going to stretch the shape open first. Before you whack, make sure you stretch your shape open first.
I think David's clear on that stuff.
Okay, so
this is a very important part.
I'm going to bring this down. I'm going to open my valve. I want to make sure that this isn't cold glass, but it's moving slightly.
Glass has a lot of paper in it.
I'll squeeze a little if I can squeeze. Okay, tap. Right off. Okay. Notice you didn't hear like any kind of loud sound. Like there wasn't like a tapping sound, like a it wasn't a brittle sound, it just kind of like fell off, okay?
There wasn't a crackle afterwards.
Okay, I'll open it up and make your sloppy cup.
Okay, so here's how I can do this differently. I can go and neck this. I can wait for it to get really, really cold. I can chill it out. Go on the inside. I can wait for it to get really, really, really cold. I'll grab it with my tool. I'm gonna chill it out. It's very, very cold. Kate will go and whack it. Hear the difference? You hear how it whacks, and I can feel a vibration go right through this thing when she taps. Okay, so what you want to do is you want to tap it actually when it's a little bit on the hot side. Okay, it's not clear. You can tap this off on a full break. It's just the same way that the arrow pumpy works. You can give it to her. But you want to mitigate press.
Which often happens. I was shunned by Jan and Mark yesterday. My cup fell down and then it like flattened in nearly 5 seconds.
And I said, I just want to go and make sure that the glass is supported when I tap it. So I'm going to go and cool it. And then I'm just going to go and lay this on my bench rail. And I can go and give it a tap. And it'll tap off. Okay. That works too.
I'm going to play with it and just black the whole thing on the.
And, you know, to go and finish this off, you know, I have to soak the. One thing about this is that, you know, every time I neck down, I make something small. Then I got to open it up, and I got to go and soak it. If you trim, you have pretty much the right diameter you need. You blow, you soak it, and you're done into the heat. No risk is. Whacking out my piece, there's no vibrations going through. I'm not like inventing all of these extra steps for me to do to go into it. But you have to learn how to trim.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Don't get me wrong, you gotta learn how to trim. Okay? So it's kind of up to you.
Is that the thing I messed up on? I didn't heat up my punty?
Maybe.
Okay.
Depends on what kind of punty you put on your feet.
That gritty one?
If you put the Mark Special on, then you don't have to use any heat to just tap it off.
Yeah, but then it might fall off of the punty.
Be careful.
Like it did twice. Already.
So your connection plate is really tiny anyway. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to go and put a brick halfway into the garage. And what it's called is a baffle. And it's going to go and keep the heat from pouring over my piece and giving it too much thermal shock. To heat this piece up, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to go and place this right in front of the doorway. And I'm just going to go and let it heat up. The piece is at room temperature. I'm just going to go and let it gently warm up. If you've got a really, really thick piece, then you're going to want to go and put your piece into the garage before we fire it up. And then we'll fire it up and then it'll come up kind of naturally. And every now and then you just want to go and push it in a little bit.
Like every 10 seconds?
Kind of like every couple of minutes. But you want to let it just kind of warm up gradually. But you definitely want to go and put the baffle in. And you can heat up any glass that you want to do. Like you want to go and open up Corona bottles or something. Or iced tea bottles. What's that? Arizona iced tea has some bottling companies have fired on labels. Instead of having paper, it's actually an enamel that's on the glass. You can go and bring them up in the garage.
What if it does have paper labels?
Cut the neck off and make a cup out of it.
Correct.
So if you've ever seen that like in the stores, that's how they do it. Or craft places.
So basically if you're doing it this way, you're committed to standing here waiting.
Well, you know, you could go and set up your bed, you know, come in. Garage is on, put your piece in there, poke it in a little bit. Go and set up your bench, do your 5-minute job, you know, poke it in a little bit more, until you do your 5-minute job.